Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to only show a specific text box on your stage screen in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had a situation where you've got text that's showing up on the stage screen and you only wanted some of it, go ahead, give me a like. Thumbs up, share this content, subscribe like over 11,000 others have, you know, all the drill. So with ProPresenter 7, it's so powerful that you can do just about anything that you can imagine. One of the things that you might run into as a problem is that if you have multiple text boxes on the screen, or let's say you have multiple text boxes on the slide and they're not even showing on one screen, you may not want one or more of those text boxes to show up. So how do you get around that problem? Well, let's head over to the computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in Pro 7, and the first thing I'm going to do is get my mouse over there. Okay, but having done that, let's go ahead and let me show you an example of this problem. So I do have my stage screen up, and when I click on this, this looks all kinds of funky. This is actually what I would expect it to look like. Well, if I hadn't been the one to make it look all kinds of funky for illustration purposes. So let me show you kind of why it's doing that, and then we'll go from there. So if I right click, go to edit slide, I could have just as easily clicked edit right there, or control E on a Mac. I think it's Alt E on Windows.
Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you.
You'll notice that I've got a bunch of text boxes here, and that's what's causing the problem. Really, what I want is I want to show the notes here in this situation. So what I'm going to do is go into screens and then edit layouts. And for this particular situation, what I'm going to do is click on this, temporarily hide myself here, and change this to notes. Okay, so now when we go back over here, and I select this one, notice it says current slide notes. That shows the notes here. So just, and likewise right here, it shows the notes. Here it shows the notes. Solves that problem completely. But what happens if I had multiple slides, and I'm not trying, well, multiple text boxes, and I'm not trying to show the notes for a thing. I want to show only one text box. So let's do this. Let's edit this same way. Right click, edit screen. Okay. And then I'm going to make a second text box here. So duplicate. Okay. Now I've got two text boxes here. And let's call this one text 2. Notice I right clicked, selected it. Okay. So this one is text 2. Click on this to hide it. And that's showing it. Okay. And now, if I go back into show mode and click on this slide, it's not exactly doing what I wanted it to do. If I have the just a regular layout here, it's not exactly showing me what I want it to do. So notice this is just showing one, died he for me who caused his pain. This one is showing two. So what would be ideal is if I could pick which text box to show. So let's head into screens and then edit layouts once again. And I'm going to select this one. I could also create one from scratch just by clicking on the plus up here and selecting this one since it's kind of a preset. Current and next text, not current and next notes, current and next text. So, and then for this particular one, what I'm going to do is, again, hide myself and change current slide text. Current slide is correct, but instead of text, let's do match element name. Okay, notice it says current slide match element name, and I'm going to type in the name of the text box that I want to show, T-E-X-T. In this case, I could have done text 2, but having it as TEXT, just as it is by default, then that should show me what I want to see. So I'm going to go back over here. Let's change this. Notice we've got two lines right here, and now we change to the one that I just created. And click on it. And that didn't do what I wanted it to do. So why didn't it? Let's right click and edit slide. Yeah, I mean that should be doing that. So capital T E X T. Let's call it text one. And then let's go into screens, edit layouts. Select that one here and change that to text one. I actually see what might have happened earlier. And let's go back to show. There we go. So that fixed it. I think that what was happening earlier was I had a space after the word text, and I think that caused that problem. So now, practically speaking, I might not want two text boxes with exactly the same thing in it, but if I go into edit slide here, and instead of just having this one here and this one here, which are duplicates of one another, what if this is the Spanish for this slide? Okay. Now, clearly that isn't Spanish, but since I don't speak Spanish, which is a bit of a detriment to me, if I go here and show you the current slide text, notice that it shows me the Spanish for the slide and the English. And if my I only wanted to show the English, then I could go into the match element name and notice that that only shows me the one text box. So that's a use case for why I would want to do that. And that is a good reason why perhaps I would want to show only a specific text box in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.